great ingredients result in a great dish. The Bible talks about ingredients that we need to add to our life in order to ensure that our life is successful, effective, and fruitful. The word Peter uses in the epistle is fruitfulness. 2 Peter 1 and verses 5 to 8, but also for this very reason, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, to virtue knowledge, to knowledge self-control, to self-control perseverance, to perseverance godliness, to godliness brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness love. For if these things are yours and abound, you will be neither barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. So the third thing that Peter lists here is discipline or self-control. Self-control or temperance or alert discipline, it refers to the control over all our desires, inclinations, and appetites. And the same word is used there in Galatians chapter 5 as well, that something that the Holy Spirit produces in our spirit. It's called the fruit of the Spirit, which is self-control, which God desires to develop in us, which God desires to produce in our heart. So self-control is more powerful and rewarding than great accomplishments, because you can accomplish great things, achieve great things in life, but if we do not have self-control, then we cannot actually sustain them. So self-control, discipline, is something which is very, very important. And the Bible talks about four areas where we can develop discipline. And the first area is in the inner man, to strengthen, to be strong in our inner man, to have that discipline in our inner man. Ephesians 3 and verse 16 talks about that, where Paul prays for the church in Ephesus, and he says, I pray that you'll be strong through the Holy Spirit in the inner man, that you will be strengthened with might in the inner man. So that is something that that we can be strong in, that we can pursue, that that we'll be strong in the inner man. And that does not come overnight. It is a process that we discipline ourselves, that we pursue the presence of God and the Spirit of God, and He puts that strength in our spirit. The second area is, of course, disciplining our mind. You know, whoever disciplines the mind actually disciplines his entire body, disciplines his life. So now our mind, many times we think we cannot control our mind. We cannot really control what goes in and what stays there. Definitely, you know, there are many things that go through, many thoughts that go through our mind, but we can choose. We can decide what stays there. We can decide what we need to think on, to meditate on, and we can choose what we need to discard. And if we are not used to thinking on those lines, or if we are not used to disciplining our mind, definitely it'll be very difficult initially, but if we can persist, it'll be like developing a spiritual muscle, that our mind will be strong, our will be strong. And Paul writes and he says, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. A sound mind, a disciplined mind, is a great asset to a believer. So that's another ingredient to add in our lives, discipline. So discipline in our minds, discipline in our bodies, discipline in our thinking, and discipline in our inner man. Let's pray and ask God to build this in us, to strengthen this in us. Father, we thank you, God, that you created us. God, we thank you that your desire is that we will be strong in our minds, that we will have this quality of discipline in all areas, in our bodies, in our minds, in our appetites, in our thinking, that we will be strong, that we will be disciplined. We thank you that you've given us a sound mind, and we pray that this quality will be manifest in us, will be seen in us. And I just pray that we live fruitful lives because of that. We give you all praise. We give you all glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.